Hi everyone, this is Cemalettin Taşken, and this week for Iran Pod, I wanted to speak about the effect of the coronavirus on the relationship between Iran and the United States. As you know, the coronavirus dramatically affected the whole world, and the COVID-19 disease continue to threaten humanity, I think. The dangerous dimension is reached by the coronavirus outbreak. It is also a test for countries, governments, and societies. The methods and the measures are taken in combating epidemic disease, which may bring about deep psychological and social change. Also reveal how management approaches and public approaches have changed, of course. Countries taking the necessary precautions when the disease began to be heard slowed the spread of the epidemic. The states that did not perceive the disease seriously suffer significant losses today. Iran is one of the countries that the coronavirus pandemic affects the most. The coronavirus outbreak has brought escalating tension between the two countries to a new dimension after Donald Trump decided to withdraw from the nuclear deal in May 2018. The shrinking economy and gradually decreasing the United States health opportunities against sanctions are the biggest obstacle for Tehran combating the disease. Despite all the negative situation in Iran, which has the maximum resistance to the United States, the maximum pressure will be a critical threshold in fighting against the pandemic in the future. The United States is not willing to reduce pressure on Tehran. Mike Pompeo, Secretary of State, thinks that the coronavirus has become the most threatening elements of the management's approach in Iran. At a time when the United States was at the top of the world in terms of several cases nowadays, according to Pompeo, with the weakening of the Iranian economy by both sanction and pandemics, the military operation option should be kept up to date. In addition to the United States' provocative attitude, the world-threatening epidemic may have brought a new period of opportunity to Tehran that it was not possible, has not been able to achieve before. According to the message given by the conservative press in Iran, Trump's insistence on the continuation of sanction has already started to change Tehran's nuclear plans. While Tehran struggles with the pandemic on the one hand, and on the other hand, the chaos across the world may have offered Iran the opportunity to conduct new nuclear studies away from the ice and away from the world. On the other hand, sanction applied to Iran, the country has once again opened an important political maneuver area to Tehran, which received serious criticism about announcing the outbreak too late and not taking adequate and necessary measure. And in addition to the economic difficulties, the biggest obstacle to the fight against the coronavirus is not an administrative weakness, but economic and political pressure. Failed development policies implemented in the country and inevitable economic contraction, corruption investigations, targeting a civilian plane by the military guard, by the Iranian guards, and protests became a tradition in the country, as you know. It offers the chance to pursue its struggle over anti-United States opposition. On the other side, on the United States side, in the evaluations made on the subject, the opinion of the Trump administration has seriously damaged and the national interest of the United States. While an economically and politically optimistic atmosphere has been achieved after the nuclear deal in 1915, Trump's withdrawal from the nuclear deal is seen as the most important reason for the progress and diplomacy against Iran. Even though sanctions have destroyed Iran's economy, Tehran is determined and successful in overcoming Washington's demands. Moreover, the pressure policy applied to Tehran can be as costly as possible for both the United States and the European Union. Even the killing of the general Qasem Soleimani, as you know, one of the Iran's most influential, one of the most efficient figures, was enough to deter Iran. And I have to point out that Pompeo's insistence on military operation can be ever riskier for Washington at this time. There is a process in which the economic contraction in Iran poses serious problems, and Iranians lose their belief that the state will cope with this crisis. However, it should be kept in mind that the options Tehran has when it's a weak are more than from the other times. In the upcoming period, especially in a period when the United States is leading the world in terms of the number in infected patients, Tehran is in a position to have obtained new opportunities that it has not had before. Because the attitude and the error that the Trump administration has taken in the fight against the COVID-19 will be serious political, social, and economic consequences for the United States. Another critical issue that the Tehran has entered a period where it will not take into consideration the economic and political reaction of the international community, because when the United States announced that it had withdrawn from the agreement, Iran had asked the European Union to react to the United States against the United States and support it. But it didn't happen, and the sanction continued to increase. In contrast, in response to the United States sanction, Tehran has abandoned certain restrictions imposed and agreed upon by the West. Ultimately, both countries tend to continue to tension despite the pandemic. So far, Trump's withdrawal from the nuclear deal and the maximum pressure policy imposed on Iran strengthened conservatives in Iran and made COVID-19 as a useful maneuver to advance Iran's nuclear plans. I want to point out that if the United States wants to influence Iran's domestic and foreign policy, it is necessary to return to the nuclear deal and reduce the economic pressure on Iran and develop policies to open a political and social diversity and strengthen the Iranian opposition. All other options mean that the management approach in Iran continues to stronger. And thank you listening me. Hope to see you for next Iran Pod programs. Have a good day.